Known as the soap maker of Correggio, Leonarda Cianciulli was Italy's first female serial killer, murdering three women in her hometown and then cooking their bodies. The worst part? She likely would have continued killing if she hadn't been caught. Cianciulli was born in 1894 in the small town of Montella in southern Italy. While little is known about her early years, some sources say Cianciulli's mother was raped by her father, and the two were then forced to marry when it turned out she was pregnant. The result was a bad marriage and a very unhappy childhood for Cianciulli, who attempted suicide twice. When she was 21, Cianciulli married an office clerk her parents disapproved of. Her mother was so angry that she cursed Cianciulli. Curses and superstition would eventually lead her to kill. Cianciulli and her husband Raffaele moved several times, once after their home was destroyed by an earthquake, before settling down in Correggio. There she became known as a kind family woman who ran a small shop. Leonarda Cianciulli was a superstitious woman and would often visit a fortune teller. During one of these visits, she was told all of her children would die. The prophecy would mostly come true. Cianciulli was pregnant 17 times during her marriage and suffered 3 miscarriages. Of the 14 children who were born alive, 10 died at a very young age for a variety of causes. With only 4 surviving children, Leonarda became obsessed with their safety. Then in 1939, Cianciulli's eldest son Giuseppe joined the Italian army to fight in World War II. Cianciulli was filled with fear and desperation, and remembering the prophecy, decided to offer a sacrifice to protect him. Rumor is that Cianciulli was a bit of a fortune teller herself. Local women would sometimes come to her for advice. That's where she found her victims. Leonarda Cianciulli's first victim was Faustina Setti, an older woman who desperately wanted a husband. Cianciulli told Setti the man of her destiny lived in a nearby town. Then she convinced her to write letters to her friends and relatives, letting them know she'd gone away to be with him. Depending on which version you believe, Faustina returned to say goodbye to Cianciulli or to pay her for her advice. Either way, Cianciulli drugged a glass of wine, and once Faustina was unconscious, she killed her with an axe. She cut the body into pieces and put them in a big pot and cooked them. Victim number 2, Francesca Soavi, had a very similar story. Cianciulli offered to help her go away, this time to a school job in another town, and told her to write postcards to say her goodbyes. When Francesca returned to pay her 3,000 lire for her help, Cianciulli drugged and killed her with an axe, then cooked her body in a large pot in the kitchen. Cianciulli's final victim was a former opera singer who wanted to start a new life in the big city. Virginia Cacioppo reportedly paid Cianciulli 50,000 lire to find her a job as a secretary in Florence, but her life ended just like the previous two victims. Although killing 3 women with an axe would have been enough to make Leonarda Cianciulli a monster, it's what she did after that made her truly horrific. In her memoir, An Embittered Soul's Confessions, Cianciulli explains how she threw the pieces of each body into a pot, added caustic soda, and mixed and boiled until the flesh dissolved into a thick, dark mush that she dumped into a septic tank. But it gets much worse. It turns out that in the case of the first 2 victims, Cianciulli used their blood to make tea cakes. Cianciulli writes in her memoir, "I waited until it had coagulated, dried it in the oven, ground it, and mixed it with flour, sugar, chocolate, milk, and eggs, as well as a bit of margarine, kneading all the ingredients together." She then gave some of the cakes to her husband and to elderly neighbors who came for a visit, saving a few for herself. When it came to her third victim, Cianciulli not only made cakes, which she explains were better because that woman was really sweet, she also melted her flesh, added a bottle of cologne, and made bars of soap, and gifted it to neighbors and acquaintances. Leonarda Cianciulli was caught because her third victim turned out not to be such a lonely person after all. In fact, the victim's sister-in-law, upset by her sudden move to Florence, reported her disappearance to the local chief of police. When witnesses came forward saying they'd seen her visiting Cianciulli's home before she disappeared, the police decided to ask some questions, and Cianciulli quickly confessed all 3 murders. Cianciulli never expressed any remorse for committing the murders and kept a cold, clear demeanor when describing the killings during her trial in 1946. In a statement that sounded like she was trying to redeem herself, she pointed out that, "I gave the copper ladle, which I used to skim the fat off the kettles, to my country, which was so badly in need of metal during the last days of the war." In one of her many visits to a palm reader, Cianciulli was told that her future would be less than stellar. The fortune teller said, "In your right hand I see prison, in your left a criminal asylum." As it happens, Cianciulli was sentenced to 30 years in jail, followed by 3 years in asylum. Her son survived the war, and both he and his father were eventually tried for helping Cianciulli with the murders. While Giuseppe confessed to mailing some postcards and letters pretending to be the victims and even tossed body parts into the river, he claimed no knowledge of any murders. Both men were acquitted. Cianciulli died of cerebral apoplexy at the age of 76 after being moved to a women's criminal asylum. Today, the Museo Criminologico in Rome holds a number of items related to her case, including the axe and pot used in the murders. If you or anyone you know is having suicidal thoughts, please call the National Suicide Prevention Lifeline at 1-800-273-TALK, 8255.